Hey guys, after more than 15 years, author Alastair Reynolds has released a new novel in his series Revelation Space. I mention novel because there have been short stories, novellas and some standalone work. Inhibitor Phase is the fourth novel in the series after Revelation Space, Absolution Gap and Redemption Arc. I would be remiss if I didn't mention I am a huge fan of the works of Alastair Reynolds. Barring a few short stories here and there, I have read all of his work, starting soon after Chasm City was released. While I think he is a brilliant writer of hard SF, there have been a few times I was less than enthusiastic. If you want a quick appraisal, I will state that Inhibitor Phase falls somewhere between brilliant and average. It is good, but not any more than that. While I believe Inhibitor Phase can be read as a standalone story, it is better if you read it as the fourth novel in a series, while also reading the standalone novel Chasm City. Revelation Space deals with a humanity that has begun to explore the hundreds of star systems in our immediate vicinity. Being forced to travel at relativistic speeds, it can take years, even decades, to travel to neighboring systems. All the while, humanity has further developed technology, culminating in the splendid colonization of planet Yellowstone in the Epsilon Eridani system. Sadly, humanity has also awakened the remnants of a genocidal alien race. The Inhibitors, as they are called, will cull any civilization when it becomes too advanced, or has in what they believe an adverse effect on the galaxy. The concept of such an alien interference is often referred to as the Fermi's paradox, a great filter, to explain the absence of aliens. It is a common theme throughout the works of Reynolds. Inhibitor Phase is set several hundred years after the first novel, at around 2700, during which most of humanity has been wiped out. A lot of this was depicted in Absolution Gap, but it is still astounding the author would double down on this, essentially destroying much of the literary universe he has created. This story follows Miguel the Ruiter. He has been hiding with a few thousand colonists in the crust of a planet continuously pounded by asteroids. By mostly eliminating electronic signaling, they hope to use stealth to avoid the attention of the wolves, the nickname for the Inhibitors. However, Miguel is rudely dragged from the colony by Glass, a bio-enhanced human who appears to know more about Miguel's past than he himself does. While initially they have strong reservations against one another, Miguel promises to go on a journey with her and find the weapon to stop the wolves once and for all. Along this journey to find a weapon against the wolves, we meet a number of familiar characters in semi-familiar locales. Yellowstone is one such location, where Miguel meets Pinky, also known as Scorpio, the sardonic hyperbig, and his associates. It is a welcome expansion of the set of characters we read about thus far. However, it does start a sequence of detours for Miguel and his journey to get the weapon. To obtain the weapon, they first need to find alien artifacts that will help them through the crushing pressure of a gas planet. Those artifacts are at the bottom of the now destroyed Chasm City. What follows is a journey to hell as Pinky reveals the cannibalistic tendencies survivors there have developed. It is a sad future for Chasm City and the glitter belt of cities that orbit it after we readers last visited it in the novel Elysian Fire in 2018. Sadly, there is also an almost offhand remark regarding the probable death of Sky, or Tanner Mirabeau, as he was also known, the main protagonist of Chasm City. After this detour is completed, more follow. A visit to Aramat, the planet of the pattern jugglers, proves to be the place where most of the story threads are completed. As suspected throughout the story, Miguel is in fact the brother of Neville Clavain, who in previous novels tried to fight the wolves. Just like a number of other characters, Miguel decided for some reason to start life over again and have his past memories blocked, something the pattern jugglers can reverse. However, the story ends on a high note. There remains doubt as to the efficacy of the weapon. It is a commentary from the author himself. Nothing is set in stone. Through entropy, everything is always in motion. I really wanted to like every single novel by Alastair Reynolds, but that is not going to happen. Personally, I never liked the Poseidon's Children trilogy much. As for Inhibitor Face, it is hard to form a judgment. It is by no means a bad story, but it is not spectacular either. There is little of the fun and tension I felt while reading Revelation Space or Chasm City. The little there is because there are characters that have been carried over from the original novels. Inhibitor Face can drag on quite a bit. It feels to me the same thing could have been said and done with less words. If the book has a beginning, a middle and an end, it feels as if the author was waiting for something before proceeding to the next phase. Perhaps not because of this, but a complementary problem is that the story becomes easy to guess, and well, halfway through I think I already know how it is going to end. Reynolds has made use of now all too familiar tropes found throughout his writing. The protagonist slowly remembering suppressed memories through flashbacks, and the detailed descriptions of physics, such as they occur when a spacecraft approaches a star or falls through the atmosphere of a planet. In Inhibitor Face, it all felt too familiar. I hope you enjoyed this review. Please click on the like and subscribe button if you enjoyed content by Alastair Reynolds and Revelation Space.